Okay, sorry.
If you love me, won't you say something? If you
every day I need you. I loved you right from the start. Sometimes I feel I've drifted off to the further stars, only to find I'm rested, wrapped in your loving arms.
It is, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Karibuni. Karibuni to Terrence's and Stacy's love story.
While on this road I've taken, the journey may seem too long, but my heart will not be shaken, 'cause you are my hope, my song. I've never seen such passion from one whose heart's so pure, for one without compassion. So how could the two endure? Ooh, ooh, ecce temico. It causes my heart to sing. Ecce temico. Valerina Ponce. Ecce temico. It causes my heart to sing. Ecce temico.
To the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why. Me.
and no other love will do. Every moment that you smile chases all the pain away. Forever and a while, in my heart is where you'll stay. This is why. The perfect time to say, I love you, 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 I do. This is why I love you. This is why I love you. No other love will do. That's why I love you.
So lost just loving you. My soul keeps calling, calling you back to a burning room. Cause we've fallen between the cracks of solitude. Now this silence crushes everything but true. Slipped away in a day till death we part. Tell me why did it change? Black and white, flawless, every breath and every line. Balance took our words, left us behind. Tell me why did it change there?
Where I what? Yes, I do. I believe that one day I will be where I was right there. Nothing without you, your touch, your skin. Where do I begin? No words can explain the way I'm missing you tonight. This emptiness, this hole that I'm inside. These tears, they tell their own story. Call me not to cry when you were gone. But the feelings overwhelm me. It's much too strong. Can I lay by your side next to you?
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to the cocktail table. Please have some bite-ins and some juice as we await the bride.
I want you to know.
My name is Njeri Ragoi Ondede. Jesus Christ is my personal savior, and I am really honored to be here to MC in Terence's and Stacy's wedding. So, karibuni sana. DJ, please give us a music to enjoy briefly.
Shukuru Mola kwa kutuleta pamoja, siku ya ndoa nitangoja, kwani we ni penzi langu namba moja.
All right, Terence's parents, I hope me practice ka dance. Karibuni sana. You are ready? Hey, sawa, DJ twende.
Say you are the love.
You are the love that never leaves. I am here to testify, Lord.
Welcome, welcome. Let's give their parents a round of applause. Haven't they done lovely, lovely dance moves? Si umefanya vizuri? Hey, sawa, sawa. Sasa hapa, we are going to shift gears kidogo. And we're going to go a bit of hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? You know, this is Terence coming down the aisle, guys. So, Terence, are you ready, my bro? Are you ready? Oh, uko tu sawa? Sawa, DJ Twende.
I see all my favorite photos when I'm low. Where did all these moments go? Where they go? I see my whole life just pass by. When did I die? I do anything I have it. Have it right back. I see all my favorite photos when I'm low. Where did all these moments go? Where they go? I see my whole life just pass by. When did I die? I do anything I have it. Have it right back. I see all these moments pass. Yeah. I see all these moments pass. Waving by. I see all these moments pass. Yeah. I see all these moments pass. Waving by, oh my, waving by. I've been feeling so blessed, oh my, 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 my. 100,000 on my wrist, oh my, my, 100 on this. It seems like you paid a whole lot of what. Tell the truth, look at you, you went snooze, nine, nine. It's a vibe, it's a vibe, that's on you, you. Going home, ride or die, don't be fool. If today we too young, that's the truth. Oh, yeah,
hey,
oh,
hey,
good.
Know you, know you.
Drives me crazy, I've been fading.
I am sweating.
They say daisies,
I'm
crazy. Drives me crazy, I've been fading. They say daisies,
come
I
on.
See all my favorite photos.
Okay, alright.
Where did all these moments go?
Yeah.
Where'd it go?
Hey.
I see my love just passed by.
Hey. Tabidi nikate DJ kidogo. Hey, let's give a round of applause to Terence. That was, hey, yo, wimbo, lazima nifanye shout out. Moments by Gavi to the online fam, you know.
in case you're like trying to Shazam and simu me hang, blah blah blah. That was Moments by Gavi. All right, now we're gonna welcome our Reverend, my friend, Reverend George Murichu, please come and take over and welcome the lady of the hour.
Let's go ahead and just be upstanding as we prepare to receive the lady of the hour, the bride, Stacy Awondo Munyoncho. And there's a special song to welcome her. And so I'd just like us to fix our gaze there. Terence, if you can zoom.
There's nowhere else to go. There's nowhere else to be than here in love with you. You know what's best for me. Reflections of myself, no shadows in the dark. You hold the light to me now. You say what's for my heart. That's why I'll always be in love with you. Still through it all. That's when we're going up, oh, going up. When we rise and fall, you know I'll always be in love with you still. Oh, 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 still. Oh, oh, yes. Oh, oh, oh. Rivers run to you. That's what comes naturally. You see what's in this heart. You know what's best for me. And the reflections of my voice, they echo in the dark. You hold the light.
that's why I will always be in love with you. Still do it all. That's when we're going up.
As Terence shows him the seat. Come on, we can do better than that, congregation. And of course, Stacy's mom as well. Let's go ahead and appreciate Stacy's mom, Karibuni Sana. And there we go. Wow, that's a beautiful picture. Terence and Stacy. The song is lovely. Friends, let's go ahead and just celebrate this lovely, lovely couple.
All my days and all my
looking glam,
and
hip and happening. There's definitely a hashtag here, and their love story is beautiful. And what better way to celebrate it than in this kind of setting? Sort of reminds us of the garden, the very first wedding, right? And we want to honor the Lord. We'll start off with word of prayer as we celebrate, as we once again just honor this couple as we go into their union. Shall we pray? Our Father and our God, thank you. Thank you for bringing us to this point, oh God. You're faithful, you are good, you're kind, you're merciful, you're gracious. Everything that is lovely comes from you. And Lord, we know that marriage is a gift from you. You're the one who started it. It's your idea. And we thank you for bringing Terence and Stacy to this place where they're entering into this covenant, oh God. Lord, we pray that you would so bless them. We pray that theirs would be a marriage that brings people to Christ, that points people to you. Lord, you've said that marriage is about that's the mystery, Lord. It's about Christ and the church. And we pray that theirs is going to be that kind of marriage. Thank you that you've brought us together, Lord. Those who are streaming virtually and those of us who are here physically, that we can share in their joy. So would you be present with us this afternoon? And we pray these things in that mighty and matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And we shout... Guys, we can do better. We are in Africa. We can do better than that. Shout amen.
Amen.
Amen. We've been energized. We've had lovely cocktails. And so as we start once again, want to welcome you, each and every one of you who's joined us. This is Terence and Stacy's big day. And we want to start off by singing this lovely song, Oceans. Spirit lead us. Spirit lead them. As they go into a new chapter, beautiful song. Let's sing together.
Hallelujah. Let's just go ahead and worship the Lord. That's a prayer. That song is actually a prayer, praying that the Spirit of God will lead us. The Spirit of God will lead. We'll look at them. Would they be able to bear witness that the Lord is present? That them, Lord, in different seasons, because different seasons will come. Whether it be winter or autumn, spring or summer, we don't have those, but Lord, rainy or cold, whatever seasons of their marriage, be the Spirit of the Lord, be that teacher, that guide, that one who will instruct them into all truth. We believe that you've heard us, O God, and we believe that that's going to be their testimony. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's go ahead and celebrate the Lord. For the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, we can lift up a clap offering because he is faithful. If you know anything about their story, you know that the Lord is faithful. He's seen them through different seasons, through different time zones, through different continents, and here they are, side by side, husband and wife, for now bride and groom. All right. Please go ahead and take your seats in God's presence. Allow me to read God's word. Shared this earlier in the service from the gospel according to John. This is John's gospel. I just want to read the very first recorded miracle of Jesus. John gives us different miracles in his gospel that point to Christ. And it's very significant that the first miracle takes place in a wedding. It's almost like God is putting his seal of approval, and he's saying, this is my thing. So Stacy and Terrence, this is God's thing. You're entering into his institution. This is his idea. It's not a social construct. We're not that clever. This is his thing. And if it's going to work, we have to do it his way. You have to do it his way. So let's read together from the gospel according to John. You can swipe your way there. Those who are streaming live, you can also join us. John chapter 2, verses 1 through to 11. On the third day, there was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus also was invited to the wedding with his disciples. When the wine ran out, the mother of Jesus said to him, they have no wine. And Jesus said to her, woman, what does this have to do with me? Sidebar, don't talk to your mom like that. Woman, what does this have to do with me? My hour has not yet come. His mother said to the servants, do whatever he tells you. Now there were 6 stone water jars there for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. And Jesus said to the servants, fill the jars with water. And they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, now draw some out and take it to the master of the feast. So they took it. When the master of the feast tasted the water now become wine and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the master of the feast called the bridegroom and said to him, everyone serves the good wine first, and when people have drunk freely, then the poor wine. But you have kept the good wine until now. This, the first of his signs, Jesus did at Cana in Galilee and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him. The word of the Lord. And we say, thanks be to God. And my prayer for this couple, these lovely friends, known them from back in the day when I was in Sitam Valley Road, 2016. Yes, seen them, been part of this journey. My prayer for you is that God will manifest his glory in your wedding and in your marriage over the years ahead. The days, the weeks, the months, into years, different seasons. He will manifest his glory like he did at that wedding in a tiny little village called Cana in Galilee. That was Shags.
that was okay, that was Ushago.
No, as Bishop Oginde usually talks about his upcountry, he says back of beyond. Kana was a small little place, but Jesus graced that small little place. Son of God visited that wedding, and he manifested his glory. And God has a way of starting small, humble beginnings, little things, and making them big. So as you take your baby steps, God will manifest his glory. And I want to just highlight three things as I did earlier. The first one is that Jesus was invited into this wedding. He was not a gate crasher. He was there by invitation. Verse 2 tells us that Jesus and his disciples were invited. The second thing we see is that Jesus was involved in this wedding. They didn't just have him as a guest who was there to be seen but not heard. They involved him. They sought his counsel. The last thing there is that they implemented what he told them to do. So friends, if you desire to see God's glory in your marriage, and I know you do, you want his glory to be real and visible, right? You want yours to be the kind of marriage that points people to Christ, young and old. And we know in our day and age, we need that. We need hopeful stories, because we have so many horror stories. We have so many horror stories of young people, old people, marriages that start well, and the wine runs out. Have you heard of those? The wine can run out. But I pray that as you invite him, make a conscious choice, invite him, start with him, honor him. The Bible says that those who honor the Lord, he will honor. He says, seek first my kingdom and its righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. In other words, prioritize me, prioritize my kingdom. Go ahead and do that, Stacy and Terrence. Invite him. Invite him into your home. Invite him through, build an altar. Build a family altar. Invite him into your home. Invite him, as I said, into your finances, into the wallets and the accounts. May there never be sniper accounts, kitchen accounts, cabinet accounts. As you will soon exchange vows and you become one, may your finances be one. And the second thing they did is these people here involved Jesus through Mary. Mary, mother of Jesus, said, the wine has run out. And there'll be times where you go through the mountain high, the valley low. What you need to do is involve Jesus. Don't let him be a guest. I told you about that wall hanging. And many people subscribe to that. Jesus is there. Unseen guest, and he's the silent listener in every conversation. I don't want that, Jesus. I don't want a silent listener. I want him to speak and give me counsel. I want him to teach me. I want him to show me the way I need to go. And the next thing we see them doing is, after involving Jesus, they go ahead and implement. They do what he tells them to do, even though it seemed ridiculous. And so it may seem ridiculous to pray together every night. It may not be in vogue, but that's what we do. We involve him and we implement whatever he tells us to do. It may seem ridiculous to live and cleave, but that's what he says. Genesis chapter 2, verse 24 says, for this reason, you live and you be united. And as you do that, I believe that God will manifest his glory in your lives and through your lives. I believe that he will do miracles. He's still in the business of doing signs, wonders,
wonderful things. There'll be times when you'll need a miracle. There'll be times when you need the supernatural. And that's where you invite him, you involve him, and you implement what he does, whatever he commands. Because those who implement what Jesus commands are those who relate with Jesus not as a guest, but acknowledge that he is Lord, his lordship. May he be Lord over Stacy. May he be Lord over Terrence. No amen. Where's my amen corner? Wife of my youth. All right. So may God write that word on our hearts. And we thank God that it's available. It's going to be available on replay because it's likely that there are many things going through your minds right now. That's good. So at this point in time, dearly beloved, we are gathered together here. This beautiful place, this lovely scenery. What a great setting, right? We're gathered here today in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is commended of Saint Paul to be honorable among all men. Therefore, it is not to be entered into by any unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons present now come to be joined. If any person can show just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together, let them now speak, or else hereafter forever hold their peace. Help me scan. Do you see any signs of resistance? I see none. And that's a point at which we celebrate. All right. As you've heard, it is to be entered into with a sense of weight. And so I'd like Terrence and Stacy turning to one another as we prepare to go to the vows. If you can lift up her veil. For the sake of photography, of capturing these moments. All right. Slowly. Wow, let's go ahead and appreciate Stacy. As you look at one another, I require and charge you both, as you will be accountable before the Lord at the dreadful day of judgment, when the secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you knows any impediment why you may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. For be well assured that if any persons are joined together otherwise than as God's word allows, their marriage is not lawful. Terence Otieng Ouma, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for her, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Amen. Stacy Awondo Monyoncho, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you submit to him and serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep yourself only for him, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Amen. Who will give Stacy to be married to Terrence? Let's appreciate Stacy's parents who are trending. Look at that outfit. Wow. And I'd just like to invite them to hold their daughter's hand as we also welcome Terrence's mom and dad, if you could join us. This is a standard. Now I know how to dress when my daughter will be going down the aisle. Wow, let's appreciate them as well. Woo! And as you hold your son's hand, you hold your daughter's hand, symbolically, let's go ahead and come together with your blessings. Receive. Amen. Amen. Wow. Wow. They've received a son they never had. And you've received another daughter. That's great. Let's hear just very briefly from the parents. I've seen there's a microphone there and a microphone here. Let's start off with Stacy's parents and then over to Terrence.
Well, we are very excited for you, Stacy, our daughter, and also Terrence. We are very excited that you met and you made a decision, a great decision to reflect the love of Christ and the church, to get involved and say we will deliberately reflect the love of Christ. For us as your parents, I know mom wants to say something, I'd also say something, that marriage is a long walk. It's one day at a time. Make today the best day. Don't think about tomorrow. Think of today as the best day. And I pray that Psalms 23 will continually guide you. Let the Lord be your shepherd. Let him lead you to green pastures. Let him show you where to feed, where to eat, and also to strengthen your relationship. May God increase you. May God bless you. The Bible says in Psalms 37:37, mark the way of a perfect man. The end of that man is peace, and that woman also. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Terrence and Stacy, we want to thank God for this day because it's a big day for you. Ours is only 5 days away from today. We got married in 5th of August, and you're getting married on 1st of August. And therefore, as we go through the motions, it also reminds us of our own day. One thing I'd want to just admonish you is that marriage is actually ordained by God. It's God's idea. And that's why so many of us don't understand marriage. And therefore, it is important that for you to be able to, you know, do this marriage God's way, that you put God at the center of your marriage. Let him build an altar which you will build your marriage, which you will always be consulting. Because if you go to it our own way, we will fail on day one before it starts. But if we do it God's way, God is going to be honored, God is going to be blessed. And we also want to thank you because it's been a long day. I know it has been a long way coming. Today has come, and we just want to give God the glory and honor. You founded your relationship in prayer and fasting, and I admonish you to continue your marriage in prayer and fasting, and may God bless you so much.
Amen. Excellent. Let's hear from this side.
Amen. Amen. You know, there's a song we sing. One heart. You have made me glad. You have made me glad, glad. But I want to say today also, to sing it for you, that you have made us glad. Amen. Amen. You have honored us. You have waited upon the Lord and not shocked us. Many parents receive shocks, you know. They receive relatives that they did not know were coming, with no invitation like the one that was given to Jesus. But you haven't done that. Amen. And through this almost 3 years, 4 years going almost, you have remained true to God's word and to the counsel that you have received from your parents. So thank you so much for honoring us, and in that way honoring God. The Bible says that if you honor your parents, that's the promise, that's the command that God gave, which has a promise with it. If you honor your parents, if you honor God, everything will go well with you and you'll have good success. So thank you so much for honoring us. And on this great day for you, we just want to pray for you that God will keep you, God will sustain you, God will cause his face to shine upon you every day. And that just as you have honored him before, as you continue to honor him, he will continue to show himself faithful and strong on your behalf. He will bless you indeed. He will extend your territories as much as you trust him. So continue to look to him, continue to trust him, because it's true. You have the privilege of us having both parents standing on either side of you who honor the Lord and who have a marriage that you can look up to. So if anything like Paul, we can tell you, follow our example as we follow Christ. In our marriage, we have endeavored to follow Christ, to follow God's word. And you have seen how we have lived our lives and our marriage. So you follow that. Amen? Yeah. You follow it. You have an example. You can't say, if everything goes wrong with your marriage, you can't blame me. You can't blame your mom. You only have yourself to blame. And I believe it's the same on Stacy's side as well. You have the example right there. So thank you so much for honoring God and honoring us. We are really overjoyed. I do not know what else to say. I could talk the whole evening. But all I can say is thank you, Lord, amen, for accomplishing this in the lives of our children. Amen. And may his presence go ahead of you as you take this next step in your lives. Yeah. God will never fail you. Amen. He will. As he has remained true to your parents as well. God bless you.
Amen. 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 I want to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Amen. If you know the song I'm going to sing, please join me. I'm just making a joyful noise. Imi ayu donying manyen karayesi ber. Imi ayu donying manyen karayesi ber. Imi ayu donying manyen karayesi ber na. Imi ayu donying manyen karayesi ber. Imi ayu donying manyen karayesi ber na. Imi ayu donying manyen karayesi ber. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now, the people who may not understand the language, the song just says, Jesus, you are so good, you have given me a new name. Amen. And today, Jesus has given me a new name. So we have a new name.
Yes.
We are Nyawanas and Correras. And I am a mother-in-law and father-in-law. And I just want to thank God. I want to talk about my son. And I know I can talk until, you know, you sleep here. But one thing is, thank God that I have had a privilege to be my child's Sunday school teacher. And so I can testify that he knows the Lord. And I was just telling him that because he was born, many children from all walks of life have gotten to know the Lord through Sunday school. When he turned 4 years and he was going to primary school, Hospital Hill, I was scared to death. I am releasing my child into the world. Lord, I know what is happening out there. What will I do? I listened to the wisdom of Mrs. Airo, Pastor Airo. And Mrs. Airo used to be our mentor. And she taught us one thing. If you want to bring your children in the fear of the Lord, make sure that you influence their peers. Yes, they are friends. And so I said, wow, this is cool.
I have a group of children here that are going to play with my children. I'll start a Bible club. And that's how I started Bible club when he was young, and the sister also. And the rest is history. I have continued to teach Sunday school. I didn't know I would teach Sunday school because I'm trained to teach big people. But because Terence was born, I had to learn how to teach children. And so I just want to thank God for giving him as a gift to us.
Amen.
Terence has honored me and the father. Very few children listen to their parents. When he was young, we told him, just like we don't want anybody to mess with our daughters, we also don't want you to mess with anybody's daughter. Go to school when you are ready to date. Tell us, don't even hide. There's nothing wrong with dating a girl. Yeah. And he did that exactly. So Terence listens. He listens. He did that exactly. And as we prayed, and we told him another condition as a believer, you don't go and fish from the enemy's side. Eh? Yes, you have to fish from the right pond. And we thank God. Stacy came, and when he told us, he's also very wise. He started by saying, "Mom, where do you come from?" and on until I wondered, why are you asking many questions? And finally, he discovered that, yeah, I am not related with Mama Stacy. Then now he disclosed. So he is wise. And it is that wisdom that I believe he is going with to the house. That he started when he was young. He believed in the Lord. It's what he will continue with. Everybody recite John chapter 3, verse 16. Mm. Terence, when he was young, and even now he remembers, it is chapter verse 17 that he says, he memorized, Jesus Christ came into the world, not to condemn, I'm paraphrasing, yeah. To save the world and not to condemn the world. Mm. And therefore, I thank God for that because it is in him. So we praise the Lord, and people who are watching us online, we really appreciate you. We love you. We love you. May Thank God you. Bless Thank you. You. Thank Amen. You for standing with us, and Terence and Stacy.
Amen.
For Stacy, welcome home. Welcome home. Mm. Now you are my seventh child.
Wow.
You're my seventh child, and my fourth daughter. And so, welcome home. We love you. You are a blessing to us. And the blessings of the Lord maketh rich and brings no sorrow with it.
Mm.
And so we welcome you with all the two hands.
Mm.
Thank you for fitting well in our family and just looking like my child. And so this was ordained by God.
Amen.
We thank God. Amen. So welcome. God bless you.
Let's go ahead and appreciate mom and dad to Terence and mom and dad to Stacy. Wise words there. And they have done that symbolic act to show that they've given their children in blessing. Amen. Thank you. Let's be seated. And as Terence and Stacy look at one another, eyeball to eyeball, is there any evidence of blushing? Okay. All right, here we go. So, hi, Terence Otieng Ouma.
I, Terence Otieng Ouma.
Take you, Stacy.
Take you, Stacy. A wonder monyoncho. A wonder monyoncho. to be my lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better and for worse, in riches and in poverty, standing with you in trials, rejoicing with you in victories, in sickness and in health, to love, cherish, and to submit, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I give you my vow.
Those are weighty words right there. We can do better than that. Thank you. Let's celebrate Terrence.
I, Stacy Awondo Monyoncho, take you, Terrence Otieng Ouma, to be my lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better and for worse, in riches and in poverty, standing with you in trials, rejoicing with you in victories, in sickness and in health, to love, cherish, and to submit, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance. And thereto I give you my vow.
Wow. We can do better. Guests, let's appreciate this lovely couple. They have some special words that they'd like to also share one with another. All right.
All right, so I had written my vows down, and then I thought, you know what, I'll just do this, like, just off the top, because I feel like I always do better like that. I also sound extremely American, so we'll just continue with that. So I met Stacy like 4 years ago. We were supposed to go to, there's a camp called Camp Sempa. Is it 5 years? Mm-hmm. Oh, as usual, the men don't know things. basically, like, we were supposed to, that was the first camp at Sitam that even me, like, our family had attended. I was actually not even planning to go, because I was like, Sasa, I have to go there and, like, teach, like, basically learn how to, like, interact with Kenyans and stuff, because I'd not done that, like, Kitambo. So then I was like, you know what, I have nothing to lose anyways. So then I decided to go. Obviously, it was super cool. We had a good time. It was a savage, but probably the best camp I've ever been to. It's like, it was so nice. We had a good time. We met tons of people. I know a lot of those people are actually watching, probably, actually. So that was legit. And then, obviously, I had to go back to the U.S., so I was thinking, Sasa, how do I do this thing? How, like, and things were a little bit complicated. So I was like, you know what? We'll see how this goes. So eventually, after thinking about it and pondering and stuff, so we decided, I was like, you know what, I'll just take my shot and see what happens, because I mean, the US is in Canada, so we'll see. So somehow we managed to make it work, doing Skype like all the time. I remember there's a time I was trying to learn piano. Nijua, she knows how to play piano correctly, but me, I don't know how to play piano. So I had to like figure out how I'm gonna be doing this, and then she would help me a lot on Skype, which is kind of crazy to think about. I was looking at those videos thinking like, wow, that's like, we tried hard, by the way. So then that happened, and then you came to visit, came to the US, came back, and then, like, as you know, obviously, and people around us know that we've been through a lot. I've been through a lot, and there's just been a lot of things that have happened. They're not perfect, they're not great, but I just think it's good that we're in this place we're in right now. I think it's dope that, obviously, like, we've had ups and downs, made hella mistakes. You guys, the people who know this, what would I do? I've made hella mistakes. I just want to say that moving forward, I feel like, and even like in the past, like we have, I think just, like, I feel like a lot of people, when they're doing their vows, they're saying, you make promises that you really can't really keep. I mean, the only promise I can make is that, like you said, I think you should just put God in first, when asked for the questions, like anytime you need
answers, ask him, and then in the long run, things will work out. So sometimes things will work out, but I think in the long run, as we can tell, things always work out. So so that's basically it for me. So here you go.
Thank you. Thank you, Terrence.
I love you. I love
you. A hand for Terrence. He signs out by saying, I love you. Yeah. All right.
Okay, I'm now the opposite of Terrence. I have to plan and write and think. So initially when I wrote my vows, it was like one paragraph. And then my best mate was like, look, it's too short. Can you just add something? So I decided I'm going to just write them down and I'm going to read them to you. So research has shown that dark chocolate is an antioxidant, improves blood flow, and lowers blood pressure, reduces risk of heart disease, and improves brain function. Terrence, you are my dark chocolate. You are the antioxidant that has made me more like Christ. Your laughter and love for life reduced my blood pressure. Your unconditional love for me has reduced my risk of heart disease. Your never-ending support has improved my brain function. You are not only sweet, but healthy. If I was told what we would go through when we began this journey 4 years ago, I would not believe it. We have experienced the highest of highs and rock bottom lows. But through it all, we have never given up on us. So today, I vow to never give up. I vow to fight for us and fight beside you. I vow to see you like Christ sees you. I am so sorry, guys. Reading? Yes, I'm nervous. I vow to see you like Christ sees you. Okay, let me start from where I started. So today, I vow to never give up. I vow to fight for us and fight beside you. I vow to see you like Christ sees you. I vow to, what have I done here? Really? Yeah, sorry, I get it. It's like I memorized half of it, so now it's like I'm going too fast. Okay, yes, beside you, so I vow to you like Christ sees you. I vow to be beside you through all that life will bring our way. You are the man God chose for me, and I love you more than words can express. You have loved me more than I deserved. You have stood by me in sickness and in health, in the good times and the bad times. Today I vow to continue doing the same and love you like Jesus does. I am in awe of what God is doing in your life, and I am so glad for the plans he has for you and us. God makes everything beautiful in his time. Today, he has made this day beautiful for you and I. Life has and will hand us a whole lot of lemons, but I know that as long as we are together under God, the lemonade will always be refreshing.
Wow.
I love you, babe.
Wow. For those live streaming, if you would know the poetry that is flowing here. Yes. So like that wedding in Cana, when the wine ran out, the Lord did a miracle. And she has said that the lemonade will always be there. Lemons may come, but you make lemonade. Beautiful words. And so at this point in time, I want to know, do you have a symbol for this love? All right, here we go. Wedding rings, beautiful wedding rings. And we'll just pray for these before we have them place the ring on each other. Let's go ahead and pray. Thank you, Lord, for this external symbol of inward love. And thank you that, Lord, you have brought Terrence to this moment. Love has brought them to this covenant. Lord, it is our prayer that covenant will continue to undergird their love. And it's our prayer that these rings will be great reminders. We're your children and we often need to be reminded. I pray that these rings will be reminders of the love that's bubbling and flowing from their hearts, one for the other. That in the days ahead, Lord, in the seasons ahead, Lord, like the rainbow reminds us of your love, may these rings remind them of one another's commitment and covenant today. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. And wedding rings serve
as outward signs, visible signs of an inward and invisible love which binds hearts together. They are made of earth's finest materials. And so love is the richest of spiritual values. As rings are without edge or seam, having no beginning and no ending, so they symbolize the perfection of a love that cannot end. So Terence, taking Stacy's ring and lifting up her left hand, Stacy's rings actually, Jatello. All right, so lifting up her left hand.
As a pledge and token of the vows made between us with this ring, I declare
you are the wife.
That you are the wife of my choice. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Wapi shangwe na vigelegele! You need to show the online audience the bling bling, beautiful. Stacy will pick the ring and lifting up Terence's left hand.
As a pledge and in token of the vows made between us, with this ring, I declare that you are the husband of my choice. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
And we all shout amen. 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 You need to go ahead and greet the people. Wow, wow, this is lovely. This is beautiful. We just want to pray for Stacy and Terence. One of the things that has abounded today is prayer. And we know that God answers prayer. And so we just want to commit them once again to God in prayer. We have some 2 seats for them. And let me invite the parents once again to join us. Lay hands on them, speak a blessing, and I'll just sum up. The rest of us, if you can stretch your hand and proclaim a blessing over them. Deuteronomy 28, may it be true. May the blessings of Deuteronomy 28 accompany them. May the blessings go ahead of them. May the blessings be behind them, beside them, all around them, Lord. May you shine your countenance on this couple. May you give them peace. Lord, we pray that you would shield them from the plans of the enemy, shield them from the onslaught of the enemy. We know that the enemy of our souls, he's like a roaring lion seeking whom to devour. Lord, it is our prayer that Stacy and Terence shall not be found. Lord, like that old song, that old spirit. Shield them from the onslaught of the enemy, from the thief who comes to steal, to kill, to destroy. Lord, we are praying for shalom in this family. We are praying for the fruit of the womb in the fullness of time. We are praying that you would order their steps, whether they stay in Kenya or in other parts of this world. Wherever they go, may they be a blessing. May the blessings of the Lord overtake them. May the blessings of the Lord envelop them. Father, we pray that you will send them help from the strongholds of Zion. We bless them. Come on, just speak a word of favor, a word of blessing over them. We give you glory. And in the words of Psalm chapter 20, I bless this couple today, Psalm chapter 20, that says, may the Lord answer you in the day of trouble. Yes. May the name of the God of Jacob protect you.
Amen.
May he send you help from the sanctuary.
Amen.
May he give you support from Zion.
Amen.
May he remember all your offerings.
Amen.
And regard with favor.
Amen.
Your sacrifices.
Yes.
May he grant you your heart's desire.
Amen.
And fulfill all your plans.
Yes.
May we who are witnessing, may we shout for joy over you.
Amen.
And in the name of our God, set up banners.
Yes.
May the Lord fulfill all the petitions.
Amen.
That we have lifted up today.
Amen.
Some may trust in chariots, others may trust in horses, but Terence and Stacy will trust in the name of the Lord. And we thank you that, Lord, you're watching over your word to fulfill it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's celebrate the Lord and this couple. Amen, amen. And as the parents take their seats and Stacy and Terence are upstanding, we just want to have a special song. I think there's a special song as they sign the certificate. We're going to sign right here.
Darling, I get so lost just loving you. My soul keeps calling you back to a burning room. 'Cause we've fallen between the cracks of solitude. Now this silence crushes everything but true.
As a minister of Christ is the Answer Ministries, and on behalf of the government of Kenya, it is my delight to hand over this certificate of marriage. This is what it reads, a snippet. Republic of Kenya, the Marriage Act 2014, certificate of marriage. And your names are here. Wow. And the number is 324367. So we just want to present this to this couple. As we put our hands together, they are legally married. Yes. And let's see where they're going to hide it. Let's see. Is it the shoe? Is it the coat? They're so organized. They even have a folder. Wow. So in this next part of the ceremony, I'll be calling up our MC, who is doing a great job. And I tell you, there are great things lined up, exciting things lined up. There's, to give you a sneak peek, there's going to be a father-daughter dance. Wow. You know, there's going to be better things coming up. So just before we do that, we're going to close this in prayer. And I'd like us to be upstanding as we receive this couple, Mr. and Mrs. Omar. If you could just put your hands together for Mr. and Mrs. Omar. Don't they look hip and happening? They are trending. Yes. Newest couple on the block. We thank the Lord for bringing you this far. And thank you for joining us and just witnessing, sharing in their joy. As we pray together, we pray that God would hear every prayer that has been lifted up today concerning this couple. Amen. And there's a very exciting part before the prayer where they turn to one another, eyeball to eyeball. Please approach Yes. Due to popular demand. All right. So at this point in time, we would like you to salute your wife. So as they hold their hands up high together and face the congregation, just hold hands and face the congregation, I'd like to declare Oma and Stacy Awondo Munyoncho have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have given and pledged to each other and have declared the same by giving and receiving a ring and by joining hands. I pronounce that they are man and wife in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost, and we shout Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We thank you, Lord. We give you glory for this beautiful day. We thank you for this beautiful couple, and that they will fulfill your purposes. They will advance your kingdom. They will do your will. Through them, your glory shall be seen. We bless them in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend George Murichu. I say Murichu, is it Murichu or Murichu? Murichu. Thank you so much. And now, as the couple walks down the aisle, as a married couple, quick announcements. If you're looking for the restrooms, you will use the main door and do a turn to your right and then another turn to your right. There's a signage on the door that you'll use. We'll be going to eat our dinner at this point. Anyway, so from this moment, we are tutaenda teke. Hey, you will think that you're in a safari rally wedding, just because of time, of course, and managing time. And, you know, in these COVID times, we need to manage time. So we will have a really short group photo over there, uko, where the couple will be going. You'll just follow them. We'll leave as the couple, the best couple, Natalie. Parents, just join in and go. And then the rest of us, as the protocol team, will be moving the chairs. So a quick one, parents, you will be eating in that gazebo. And then the rest, there is a banquet laid at the back. There are place cards. And in case you have any questions, the ladies in maroon with long hair, big hair, zina wanafanana tu, waulize where to sit, they will direct you. But obviously the big chairs that look like peacocks are for Mr. and Mrs. Terrence. So let's go. Oh. DJ.
Brothers and sisters, I want to walk. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love the most unlovable part of me? Of me. Just see your life. Thank you.
promise that never fails. It's indescribable, what you mean to me. Would you be my Juliet and I'll be your Romeo? So I was asked to do this video, and I really didn't know what to say, so I figured that I might as well tell you things that I admire most about Terrence and Stacey as individuals. So to me, Terrence is two things. He's protective and generous. When we were living in Tunisia, the first time I really appreciated having a brother was when I came home. Hi everyone, my name is Sheridan. I am Terrence's sister. The first thing that came to mind when I was thinking of writing this wedding speech was about 5 years ago. I remember talking to Melanie and Natalie and being like, guys, in 5 years Terrence could be married and like he would have a whole wife and it would be like so weird. And I remember just wondering like, how would she be like? Like, what would she look like? Would we even get...
Nice.
So some good news is we have a starter. Nanza na buns and soup. Prepare your stomach. So after a few photos over here, we would like you guys to be seated. Then the catering team will serve you.
Hi everyone, my name is Sheridan. I am Terrence's sister. The first thing that came to mind when I was thinking of writing this wedding speech was about 5 years ago. I remember talking to Melanie and Natalie and being like, guys, in 5 years, Terrence could be married and like...
Hi, Stacey. I just wanted to start off by saying congratulations to you and Terrence. I'm so happy for you and I'm so excited. I'm glad that you found someone you believe is going to love you and care for you the way you deserve, and that Terrence is someone you believe you can build a partnership with for life. I can't wait to see the life that you two build together. I'm sure it's going to be so beautiful and filled with so much love and laughter. And I pray most of all that you maintain God in your relationship forever. I wish we could have been there with you today, but of course we'll still be watching you. We are so excited for you, and I just wanted to let you know that we love you so, so, so much. Enjoy the rest of your day. Hi, Stacey. I just wanted to start off by saying congratulations to you and Terrence. I'm so happy for you and I'm so excited. I'm glad that you found someone you believe is going to love you and care for you the way you deserve, and that Terrence is someone you believe you can have a partnership with for life. I can't wait to see the life that you two build together. I'm sure it's going to be so beautiful.
Hi, Stacey. I just want to wish you such a happy wedding day. You are going to be the absolute most beautiful bride, and I can't wait to see pictures. I wish I could be there to celebrate with you. I am praying for you and Terrence's marriage. Being married is one of the best things in the whole entire world. So you guys are going to love it. And again, congratulations, guys. Love ya. Hi, Stacey. I just want to wish you such a happy wedding day. You are going to be the absolute most beautiful bride, and I can't wait to see pictures. I wish I could be there to celebrate with you. I am praying for you and Terrence's marriage. Being married is one of the best things in the whole entire world. So you guys are going to love it. And again, congratulations, guys. Love ya. Hi, Stacey. I just want to wish you such a happy wedding day. You are going to be the absolute most beautiful bride, and I can't wait to see pictures. I wish I could be there to celebrate with you. I am praying for you and Terrence's marriage. Being married is one of...
to hear about this journey. May your lives be filled with love, blessings, happiness, joy, all the good things that are out there in the universe. Congrats.
Hi. Hello. So we're back together. We figured after doing our serious speech, our loving speech, we would
you have to be the funny one. What do you mean?
Can we be Omas and not be funny?
Not.
Yes, we are father's daughters.
Always.
So anyway, so this one is for our joint congratulations.
Of course.
Our joint love. Our joint Manze, we miss you. We said we're not there, but
okay, we're hoping the feelings are passing through this camera.
Yes, please.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, just congratulations.
Miss you guys. Wish you were there. Yes. You know, I would be rocking a beautiful dress right now. Please. Bridesmaid ding down the aisle, but it's okay, it's fine. I'll do it through YouTube, it's okay. You'll see me. Stacey, just imagine me in your mind as you're walking down. Me and Melanie, just in front, just walking.
Mm-hmm. We're really glad to have an extra sister. What are we for now? We're four sisters.
Why did I have to come? If I don't know. Yes, we are four.
Okay.
I'm four and a half. You come to Vala. I know technically you are little.
I'm so excited for you and Terrence. I love that you guys have set it up this way that we could witness this amazing special moment. I'm so thankful that God has placed such a godly woman into Terrence's life, and I just know that you're gonna make the perfect helpmate for him. So yeah, I'm just so blessed to know you guys, and I just pray that this is the sweetest day and that you enjoy every single second of it. I just love you so much, and I wish I could be there in person, but I can't wait to watch. I love you. Stacey, happy wedding day. I'm so excited for you and Terrence. I love that you...
Terrence, Stacy, congratulations. I wish you guys the best. I hope I see you soon and that you have a long and prosperous marriage with no disease. When I'm broken down and I'm bruised, I'm gonna give myself back home. Terrence, Stacy, congratulations. I wish you guys the best. I hope I see you soon and that you have a long and prosperous marriage with no disease. Terrence, Stacy, congratulations. I wish you guys the best. I hope I see you soon and that you have a long and prosperous marriage.
So you come from that road there. And I need some. We'll put a sign here. And this is the entrance to the driveway. The security will be here. Then driveway. Okay, so now we have the gate.
Happy wedding day! I'm so excited for you and Terrence. I love that you guys have set it up this way that we can witness this amazing, special moment. I'm so thankful that God has placed such a godly woman into Terrence's life, and I just know that you're gonna make the perfect helpmate for him. And so, yeah.
Thank you.
Siku zaenda, ciencia amaba, vamos y ama. Si eres falla, vamos falla. No te por qué te largas. Si no te opes, tú ten sentimiento para andar. Sí, ya no me quedo para dormir, baby. Quiere que vos. Tu amor ya fue, te voy a volver.
Mapenzi ya dhati ya shatubana na harufu ya muziki shatuzingira sikwiki siringi dondosa. Oh yeah baby come closer.
Kwetu alisha kupenda, kwako nilisha sarenda. We ain't got no time, siku zaenda, na siku zaenda. Kwetu alisha kupenda, kwako nilisha sarenda. We ain't got no time. We can fall in love again. I wanna do it all again. With you, with you. We can fall in love again. I wanna do it all again. Dance with you. Kwetu alisha kupenda, kwako nilisha sarenda. We ain't got no time, siku zaenda, na siku zaenda. Kwetu alisha kupenda, kwako nilisha sarenda. We ain't got no time, siku zaenda, na siku zaenda.
Kwetu alisha kupenda, kwako nilisha sarenda.
Thank you. Sweet, and the way you move and hold me tight. Ooh.
Your flawless skin, the spark in your eye.
Sweet African daughter, I wanna bring cows to your mama.
You make me say yeah.
Baby, let me take you for a ride to another place where you...
All right, as we wait for the speeches, Terrence and Stacy, congratulations. I hope you're enjoying the meal. Enye ilipikwa na Ketaras. You know, I would like to give a small story. Hey, how I met Stacy and Terrence. I met them at that camp. That camp that they mentioned. Camp Semper Fidelis. Hey. Where I'm sure Terrence was ready to buy the ticket. Manze. They were ready to buy the ticket to go back to US. Watu wa hatu yeyuki. I'm telling you, life is so interesting. At that time, I think Stacy's eyes were on another person. Hey, atakuwa naona Terrence. So funny. Na kumbe Terrence ako hapo. Ati, you know who it is. Si chomi. Nasema tu story. Hii story ya Terrence na Stacy. Venye imeni.
Thank you.
Karibu, you can use the microphone.
Hello, good evening. Again, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. As I said before, if I was to talk, given the amount of joy and excitement in my heart, it would take the whole evening. But the MC has graciously given me 1 minute. And in my village, 1 minute lasts like 4,000 seconds. Yeah, but we thank God. We want just to give glory and praise and honor to God, even as we welcome Stacy into the Ouma family. We thank God for his faithfulness in our own lives. Because God has been faithful to us, that's how come he enabled us to be able to have a son and even have daughters. And without God blessing us with a son, we do not have the privilege today to have a daughter-in-law. So we give God all the glory and all the praise for what he has done for us. We are excited that he has added to our numbers, although my brother on the other side believes he's the one who has benefited more. But I think maybe he's trying to apply Philippians, which says that in humility you should count others better than yourself. Praise the Lord. So as Terence and Stacy start their new life, we just want to say again, we have said this before, we'll continue to say it, that may the Lord be with you, may he bless your marriage, may he stand with you. And as we shared with you before, God is faithful. All our lives, as our brethren have liked to sing, the Bethel brethren, you have been faithful. And as long as you give me breath, I will sing of the goodness of the Lord. And so today is another demonstration of God's goodness to me, to my family, and to Terence and Stacy. We have been praying for you. The fact that we are here in itself is a testimony to the fact that God does answer prayer. You know that several months ago we were discussing this and you were thinking of postponing everything because we couldn't make it due to the COVID situation. But we told you that really, if we cannot make it for any reason, you should go ahead and, you know, and consummate your marriage. Because you picked the 1st of August in answer to prayer. And since you picked that date, you have been praying about it. So COVID or no COVID, the 1st of August, and as far as we were concerned, was still God's will for them. And we told them that really our being here was not that important. Because, I mean, it is God, marriage is God's idea, and the two of them are the ones who are getting joined into marriage. We have done so far everything that we could as parents to show them that they have our support. And we have done everything that we could do in order to facilitate that. So our being here physically was not that important. But their being there themselves, and at least a minister, Reverend, to be able to, was graciously taken the whole day to be here. The fact that they are there and they will be a servant of the Lord to be able to preside over the event. For us, that was what was important. And we told them, you can go ahead. We'll be praying that God performs a miracle that we come. But even if we don't come, go ahead, because this is the day that the Lord has made. Even if you have to attend it via Zoom or whatever means, we will by all means do that, because that means that's God's will for us. Because if we are postponing because of COVID, when is the right time to marry? Next year? When they are telling us COVID is going to take another 2 years or it's going to stay with us? You know? So anyway, so the fact that we are here is a miracle of God, and it is a testimony to us that God is in this marriage, that God picked this day, and that God wanted them to do and to take this important step. And that's why he brought us. By his grace, I was telling somebody in Abidjan, I was telling him, God literally, as the children of Israel would say, got us out of Abidjan with a mighty hand. With a mighty hand.
Amen.
Amen. And so we thank God that we are here. So as you start your new life, I'm saying all these things to tell you. Mm. The point really I'm trying to make is to say, please do remember that God is faithful. Yes. God has been faithful to us. God has been faithful to you so far. And that same God, he does not change. So as you move into the next step, you have had enough, actually. You've been told so much. And all that you need to do is to diligently follow it, do it. Jesus said that whoever hears what I say and does it is the wise person. The one who doesn't do it is the foolish one. Because for both of them, there will be trouble. There will be storms and floods. But the wise person who hears and does, they will stand. Their house will stand because it is built on a rock. So build your marriage on the rock by applying God's word, by default, and by choosing to love each other. Love is a choice. And it's a choice that you're going to have to make every day. Every day. There will be times when you will upset each other, knowingly or unknowingly, but you have got to choose to love. For God so loved the world. Because God loved us so much, we can love the same way. So, as you go, we release you in the power of the Lord. We pray that the hand of God will be upon you. As Paul told the Ephesian elders, I commit you to God and to the word of his grace that is able to keep you and to sustain you. Amen. God bless you.
Amen. Hey, you've spoken for the Umas. Amaji. Hey, apo umeongea for everyone, even mom. Sasa mama atasema nini? Apa, we talk up to tomorrow. Hey, mom, unaona 1 minute utaweza? Okay. Nitakuwa tu hapa. You can do all things through Christ who gives you strength. Amen.
Good evening, everyone. Everybody that is here and them that are live, we want to continue to thank God. As Baba Terence has said, it is a miracle that we are here. And the events that have taken place, the way God has answered our prayers, one by one, is a testimony that God is in this wedding. In this marriage, God is there. And so, as it has been said, don't leave God behind. Walk side by side with God. And I would just like to tell you that unlike poles attract. Yes. So you need to know that you are not the same person. Each person have their own temperament. And you have to start working on it so that you can be one as God has said. We have released you, Terence, we have released you to your wife. And Stacy, I have done my job. Now I hand it over to you,
Terence,
graciously. So I want to see how you are doing it. But from afar, I tell people, I am going to be a mother-in-law with a difference. Because of what?
Amen.
Because of Christ. I know there are mother-in-laws that we see on TV and all that. There are even others that are called mother-in-law. So there's this thing called mother-in-law syndrome. I refuse it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because I am delivered.
Amen.
And I know it works. If I sat here to give you testimonies where God has gone against the odds, you will not live here. And so I believe that Stacy is going to enjoy in our home because Amen. She's a blessing.
Amen.
Yes. And that's why I'm not worried. I'm not crying. Why Amen. Should I cry?
Amen.
A blessing is coming to us.
Amen.
And our son has gotten a good thing.
Amen.
The Bible says, he who finds a wife
finds
a good thing. Amen. And so we thank God.
Amen.
And Terence, I want to tell you that if it was not COVID, your aunties, your cousins would have been here. Actually, it's unfortunate that Zoom could not work. Dan sent his greetings from Washington. He said, although COVID was there, a cousin's wedding cannot go without a gift. And so he said that I tell you that he will think of the best gift for you. And we have aunties and cousins and Granny Felgona and Sammy Otieno, Mama Teddy. They've even sent photos. I don't know how. They say they are here. They said we are watching and we are live. So receive greeting from everybody else that would have want to be here. And we want to tell them that we love them and we thank them also for showing love to our son. Thank you so much. God bless you. And to everybody, I believe this is the last.
I also believe so. We also believe so. We are all believing.
I know there will be vote of thanks that will come. We'll do vote of thanks. But I just want to thank everybody who stood in the gap for us, especially my sister and Rose, Haemba, who is the owner of this home. She has worked hard, very hard. Amen. To make sure that things work. She assured me, I am there for you, my sister. Even if you don't come, I will be there. But immediately you arrive, I will go and sit. She didn't sit because I was still quarantined. And maybe that's why you are not seeing her here. She looked at things and she said it was beautiful. So she said, my sister, I am going to rest because things are good. So thank you very much, Sister Rose. God bless you and may God keep you and watch over you and your family. And to everybody else who came, the Lord God Almighty is the only one that can bless you.
Amen. Amen.
May you go well and send our regards to your family.
Amen. Amen. Thank you and God bless you. Thank you. Let's appreciate them. As they are coming, let's have the Monyonchos come in. Karibuni sana. It was too high. Hey. I believed in your height. Karibu sana. Sijui niseme mchungaji. Unajua sasa utatuambia hapa. In conclusion, tunafungua kitabu cha Revelation.
Don't worry.
I don't worry.
First of all, let me congratulate Bwana na Biarusi. Congratulations. You have worked hard and God has helped you. God bless you. Thank you very much. I think for me as your dad is to let you know that we have the confidence that God is able to keep you, God is able to protect you, and God is able to ensure that the desires of your heart are met in this marriage. I wish you the Lord Jesus Christ. Keep him in front, not in the boot. I think you've heard of the story of these people who are on a journey and they never believed that God mattered in their lives. So they put a tray of eggs in the boot. Along the way, of course, they had a small accident. They had a very serious injuries. But the eggs in the boot, where they are told God to go and stay, the eggs were okay. The eggs never broke. So don't send him to the boot. Let him stay with you. All right? Remember the Lord thy God. I also want to thank all our friends from diaspora, from outside the country, friends from Australia who streamed in, from Germany, from America, from UK, from Tunisia, all over, just sending accolades, saying congratulations, and may your marriage continue to prosper as you continue to serve the Lord. Terence, welcome. I know your dad doesn't play football. So I'm telling him, football team is this side. So if Terence doesn't appear there, you know where he is. We are playing football, and I told him I have a new ball in the house. So this is the boy The son, I never had. So now, can you imagine? Him, at least he has daughters. I have no sons. So it's me who is benefiting. Thank you very much. God bless you. And all the other members who've been watching, streaming live, please, we truly appreciate. Thank you for all the gifts that you've sent. We are grateful and we are thankful. May God also abundantly water your camp. Amen.
Amen. Okay.
Okay, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Good evening. It's not so often that people would go for a wedding and still be in a reception at a time like this. But we want to thank God because he has given us this opportunity to come and celebrate the union between Terence and Stacy. It's actually very interesting because if you are to start talking about the history of where they started, each one of them will probably need a conference, a three-day conference just to discuss the two of them. And maybe I just like to take a small opportunity to say something about Stacy. In our house, we have two daughters. There's Valerie and Stacy. And Stacy is actually the younger one, and the last born in the Monyoncho family, and therefore she is a baby. And last night when I was going to bed, it just struck me that actually Stacy is getting married, and tomorrow she's going to be somebody's wife. And I said, Terence is raiding the cradle. But I want to thank God for the Uma family because, many times the mothers would be crying on a day like this, but you've not seen me shedding any tear because even as we've been praying for our daughters and God brought Terence and, by extension, the Umas along the way, we are comfortable that Stacy is going to a home which fears God. And we've brought her in the love and fear of God and honor of God from the time she was young. And she has not wavered. She has not deviated. Because when you dedicate the children, we dedicate them to the Lord. And we can be able to say that since she was born, she has not deviated from the ways of God. For that, we thank God. It's not by might. It's not by power. It's but by the Spirit of the Lord. The other thing I would also like to, as I have been telling you, we spoke at length yesterday, and I think we've said everything that needs to be said. If there's any other thing that needs to be said, we'll probably call a family conference and we'll talk about it. So I don't want to take so much time for the other people. I just want to just wish you all the best. Continue to honor God as you've honored your parents, as you've honored us. When you were going to the U.S., my heart was in my mouth because Terence was in the U.S. and now you're going to the U.S. I wasn't sure whether you're going to come back. And I told you, I'm not coming to the U.S. for a wedding. And we thank God that you honored that. And you came back after your studies and, did your wedding. We'd have wanted a lot more people. We had a guest list of 700 people, and we have ended up with only 15. And even that, we thank God. I mean, they reached a point to look at us and Bora Rusi. Because we didn't even know whether the wedding was going to happen. But the fact that actually we're able to gather here and celebrate your wedding, we thank God. So we also just want to thank many, many people. Actually, we are going to compile all the messages that we have received from around the world, from around Africa, from the different fellowships in Kenya and abroad. We have brethren from Nairobi Gospel Center, where we fellowship and minister. We have some representatives here, two deacons and a wife, who are not just here by the capacity of being a deacon, but one of them has actually worked with Stacy since Sunday school. She was Stacy's Sunday school teacher. So if you need somebody who can write a story about Stacy, there is somebody here, Deacon Rosemary Opeto. Just Salimia Watu. And then there is Deacon Geoffrey Kadu and his wife, Carol. And they're not here by the capacity of being deacons, but they actually have a personal relationship with us. There are so many people who would have wanted to be here, but somehow they made it here because they know they've played a very, very special role in the life of Stacy and, by extension, Terence. And then we also have Victory Fellowship, brethren from Victory Fellowship. I know you are watching us from diaspora. Please receive greetings, and we thank you so much for the messages of goodwill for Stacy and Terence, for the gifts you've sent. We have our neighbors in Kileleshwa, actually, the region court neighbors. Thank you so much. I know you are watching online. You've sent your gifts. You've sent your messages of love. We have the families, the Maina family, where I'm actually married, where we come from. We thank you. You've done so much. You've given. You've sent your messages of love. We just want to thank you. Also, my family, the Awondo family, my brothers and sisters, actually, they are not able to be here because of the numbers. We thank you for being there for us and for Stacy. We know you love them. We know that if they despite the fact that you're not able to get here, you know the kind of relationships we have, and you know we'd have actually wished you to be here. So with those few remarks, I just want to say thank you very much. May you continue to honor God, and may you continue to honor your parents, and as you continue to grow in love with one another, also grow in love with God. So God bless you so much. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much. We appreciate you. Moving on swiftly, very fast, I would like to call Mrs. Murichu. Mrs. Murichu. Mimi nasemanga Murichu. So, karibu sana Patsy. Patsy is a friend of mine for over 10 years, and I'm glad and honored to know her. Yani siamini tumefika level ya kukata cake. Yani Patsy weni anti wa cake. So karibu sana. You should be receiving a mic at this point. Yes. So you can head towards the cake. Karibu sana. Okay. So unaza watu wa online habari yenu. Kuna wenye tunenanga weddings and we just tunakonga tu tukichapa story when people are doing the cake. So we're like, when does the bride come? So at this juncture, I know the auntie wa cake is the one who calls you guys, but just start standing and come in. But Patsy will call you. I'm just waiting for a microphone for her to use that she'll receive right now.
Hello. Hi. I'm Auntie Wakeki.
Hey.
It is such an honor. Yes, I need the bride and groom here. Tafadhali. This is your first meal. I'm trying to remember everything that is said at weddings, guys. Just. Yes, so I have to write it down so that I at least I don't forget what I want to say. So, Terrence and Stacy, congratulations. We are so, so happy for you. We're so happy that you made it to the 50. Yeah, so I just want to talk a bit about Stacy and how I know Stacy. Yeah, Stacy especially, we met in 2014, and she was there with her sister at the so basically she came in when she's known my husband and I before we got married. So she's been there with her sister all from the beginning, and she actually did our cake for the graduation, for the graduation. Then Valerie did my bridesmaids dresses. So these two ladies are very close to our hearts. And and they also did the first photo shoot for when Eden was born. So it's really special that on your wedding we get to celebrate with you. And you've been there for many of our firsts, so we're glad to be here. And also when you guys started dating, thank you for involving us right from the beginning. I remember that Java breakfast. So it was really great. And so we're really happy that this day has finally come. We know, you know, the journey has been long, but we thank God for his faithfulness. So we're going to cut the cake. So as you can see, this cake was made with many it was made with many ingredients. Yes, of course there's salt, sugar, flour, oil, a lot of things, you know. And So basically, it has to go through. So after you mix all that stuff, you have to put it through heat, right? In order for the cake to bake and be ready for consumption. So I really, when I saw the heat part, I was like, by the way, sorry. I was like, oh, by the way, that's true. Like, for it to come out as a cake, it must go through the fire process. Oops, sorry, guys. It must go through the fire process. And just like this cake, yeah, your marriage will also be full of sweet things. It could have some sour things, and it will have to undergo heat in order for it to be refined. So I just want to read just one verse that talks about heat. And as an encouragement that in the Word of God, when there's anything about fire, refiner's fire, it's God taking us through a process. So don't be alarmed if you have to go through some moments of heat in your marriage. Sorry, I've forgotten where my guys. E-technology. I always confuse some two verses, but don't worry. I'm going to get it now. Yeah, so don't be worried if you go through some heat processes. It's also to just refine you, and at the end of the day, it shall be well. So I wanted to read 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 3. That's not the verse I want to read, guys. I can't find it. But anyways, it was about refining. It was about how God takes us through a process. I will text it to you because of time. But it's about taking you through a refining process. So I just really, because you're a baker and you know this thing, so I just thought, wow, heat is a very important factor in baking. And heat is also important in your marriage, and it will bring you guys closer. And as you go through that heat, I pray that you'll grow closer to God, and that as you grow closer to God, you'll grow closer to each other. And God will be with you as you continue. So, yeah, God bless you. Yes, yes. Now we are going to cut the cake. Please get the...
It's been 3 long days.
So yes, the bride and groom are going to cut the cake on 1, 2, 3. Go, everyone, do it.
The more I wait,
wow.
No, let our love fall down. We must stay afloat. We will never drown.
It has to.
Darling, you mean much more to me. So let us not allow.
Stacy is cutting the cake like an expert. Oh, you hey! Online people, Stacy baked her cake.
Yes, Stacy baked her cake. Yeah,
yeah, don't let our love go to waste. Maybe I am wrong. Maybe I should call. No matter again if now you're wrong. I go swallow my pride today. We no need to drift away. No, let our love fall down. We must stay afloat. We will never drown. You mean much more to me. So let us not allow our love fall down. Let it not fall down.
So I would just like you guys to feed one another. Oh, wait, before we feed one another, the best man, isn't the best one the one who opens the champagne, the champagne, best man, I think you should open it
champagne
before they feed each other.
Don't fight if it's for the sake of fighting. We can find a better way to resolve our misconceptions of each other. You say this, but I hear the other. We might be reading in between lines that don't exist at all. Her hand and says, I can take a bullet for you. But love is
and now because of time, I will kindly ask the Umas and the Monyonchos to please come closer to where we are, from where we are cutting the cake, please, to receive their cakes. The bride and groom have served the best couple. Best man, could you do us the honor of opening the champagne, please? The champagne, please. I gotta tell you a little something about yourself. You're one of our flawless. Ooh, you a sexy lady. But you walk around here like you wanna be someone else. Ooh, whoa. I know that you don't know it, but you're fine, so fine. Fine, so fine. Show you when you're mine, oh mine, mine, oh mine. Treasure, that is what you are. Honey, you're my golden star. You know you can make my wish come true. If you let me treasure you, if you let me treasure. We're gonna have the bride and groom please feed. Oh, okay. What thing are we doing?
How you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall. Get your back up on the wall.
These guys are 21st century couples. They don't wanna be cheesy. Yeah? Congratulations again, yes. So just moving on swiftly, we would like to, I'd like Mr. and Mrs. Mr. and Mrs. Ouma to present a cake to Mr. and Mrs. Monyoncho.
talk. Give me what you're planning to move. Tell me, baby, how you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall, get your back up on the wall. Tell me, how you gonna do it if you really won't take a chance? By standing on the wall, get your back up on the wall. 'Cause I heard all the people saying, get down on it, get down on it, get down on it, get down on it. When you're dancing, get down on it.
That is appreciation for all your hard work. Thank you. Thank you for being here today.
If they point gun to my head, say make a deny you, I gon' tell them say lie, don't be like.
So the next gig, Mr. and Mrs. Ouma are presenting. Mr. and Mrs. Ouma Jr. are going to present to Mr. and Mrs. Ouma. Otieng, yeah? Otieng. Yes, Mr. and Mrs. Otieng. See, I'm being taught. Mr. and Mrs. Otieng are presenting the cake to Mr. and Mrs. Ouma.
I'm beginning to fall in love.
Mom and Dad. Lovely, lovely, lovely.
Wow.
Thank you. I have been your Auntie Wakeki for the day. It is 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 13. That's the one. I got it from
you. Okay, thank you, Patsy. Before Stacy and Terence go, hey, tufungieni tu na maombi. Apo sasa, kwenye tumefika, we are on scratch to reveal at this point. Dark chocolate, haonekani sana. Vote of thanks na maombi, please.
All right. Just wanted to say thank you to everybody who's watched online and everybody who came here. Just want to say thank you and... yeah, looking forward to seeing you guys in life.
Thank you so much, guys, for supporting us. Those people who are online, those people who came here, we felt the love and we really appreciate it. And just continue to keep us in your prayers. And we pray that God may also bless you abundantly for the blessings and the love you've shown us. Yeah.
Wait, I'm the one praying. Okay, sounds good. I'll do that. Sounds good. Let's pray. Lord, thank you for today. Thank you for just helping us being able to just be here today. And I pray that moving forward, that everything may continue going well, Lord. You may be able to protect us and take care of us as we move out of here and as we go do the things we'll be doing for the families and everybody, that everybody may just have a good time at home and get home safely. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you very much and see you guys soon.
All right, so please let us start leaving so that the service providers can sit down. There's also a lot of cake to carry.
Hala tu cuerpo alegría Macarena, que tu cuerpo pa dar la alegría y cosa buena. Hala tu cuerpo alegría Macarena, Macarena. Hala tu cuerpo alegría Macarena, que tu cuerpo pa dar la alegría y cosa buena. Hala tu cuerpo alegría Macarena.